Hey everyone, Melcadrien here. We're back with more Paradox Lost. Let's continue our explorations for 100%. That's a... Really? Okay. Okay. Let's see if we can do this without having to use those things. And since we can't aim downwards, it's not exactly going to be possible. So, let's at least give it a shot. Give it a shot. Jeez. Alright, one more try. But this time we wait for the right moment. Yeah, there's just nowhere gonna be able to get across there. So, that route is pretty much moot. Actually, there are crystals over there. Now that I remember. I wonder if we can use those. Yeah, there is a point in time here. Let's see. And there's another person in there? Alright. Well, let's just look for some more crystals and see if we can find any more chrono points. More nodes. I believe we already went this way, didn't we? Yes, we have. Alright, so... Where can we go now? Well, I suppose the best way to figure that out is to look around, see if there are any more temporal points, well, temporal crystals, and see if there are any nodes there. And with our little chrono scanner, we can see what's there. Certainly saves us a whole lot of trouble, I can say that much. We just have to find those points and see if we can make use of them. Let's see. Let's head upwards. Yes, there is something up there, and I believe we've not fully explored up there, if I remember right. Last I checked, anyways. Yeah, there's still that spot over there. Looks like there is no way through in there, just a whole lot of nothing. Did we already check the past here? It looks like we have, but not the present. Yes, there is something here. And a good thing too, just found another hostage. Now let's use this to head into the past. Let's see. probably will have to... Actually... Nothing but null points there. So we're just gonna have to go forward in this. Well, there's something here. But I believe we already explored that area. Okay. Yeah, it's pretty much a whole lot of jumping back and forth between time, that's for sure. We've already been this way. Is there a No, there's nothing but null points there. Let's see. Where have we not been? Well, we've been up there. At some points. We're still missing one ability, and I've... Wonder where it could be. Looks like I've thoroughly explored everything in the future. Not the past there. There's still a bit of a gap there. There's still that bit there in the present. But since it's a null point, there really isn't much to worry about that. So, let us go back up this way. So long as I don't kill myself in the process. Give me that heart. Thank you. Oh, why didn't I think of this before? Well, if I don't find anything this way, in the past or the present, well, I'm probably sure we already have. In fact, we probably already have done so. Still, we can always look to make sure. And then we need to get 100% map completion anyways. So it's probably a good idea to do this in... anyways. Just have to get all the way over here. There is a crystal over here. And there's a point in the future as well. Okay, nothing. So the present. Right there. Oh, that's nice. That's actually very nice. if I do the scan, it pretty much freezes them. Like a sort of barrier. That actually... In fact, I can actually use that. I can use that to my advantage. I just have to turn on the scanner and let the freeze shield help me. Let's see. Oh, that actually is gonna help us in what we need to do. Not only that, but we won't have to worry about getting hurt. All we have to do is just keep it on and wham bam, thank you ma'am. All we have to do is just get back to the origin point. Let's see, was there anything over there? Yes, there's that, but that just takes us through the loop. Oh, that is genius, guys. You guys are geniuses. It searches for points in time, you know, no points and whatnot, but if you have it to the temporal freeze, it freezes everything within your range. That really, really helps us. Except it doesn't help us with that paradox toxin. Yeah, let's call it paradox toxin or paradox poison. Or just a pile of paradox. Alright, save. Turn this on. And now, with this on, we can... Oh, man. Design genius. Design genius. Alright. Alright. All we have to do is just jump back up. Not that big of a problem with our temporal freeze shield. Or temporal freeze bubble. That still does not help us on where we need to go next. Hmm. Because we still have a lot more to search. But the problem is that, well, we require something. At least that's what I think we need. Yeah, there is something up there. But this is one great big null point, so that's not gonna work. Where can we go? There's still that point in the prison, but it's probably an empty block. Everything in the future's been explored, as far as the eye can see. That room there in the past has not been fully explored, however. It's just so puzzling because you have to correlate between all three points in time to see if there's something we missed. And so far, I don't see any problems. At least none as far as I can see. I mean, the only point I see that hasn't been fully explored is up there, where the... where the room isn't fully explored. That's as much as I see so far. So let's just head that way and see what we can find. See if there's anything we can use. Of course, there's a point in the future. There just doesn't seem to be a point in the past. There's something down here. But where is the question? That's the biggest question I have. And there isn't anything obvious that tells us. So... let's just see if I can get this as far to the right. See if I can slide. Nope. Nothing there. And there's nothing there. And I can't just hit my head. There's something right there, but without a platform, you can't... actually... There is something right here, it looks like. I wonder if I can... No. That's a definite no. We would need some sort of platform. A platform we don't have. So, what are our options here? Since that's the only place we haven't fully explored, since the barriers that we can't even get through. This is very interesting. a whole lot of exploration. We did find something as a result. Something, at least. We still have two problems, though. That point and that point up there, they're all blocked. Last I remember. Now, unless we have something to open it, which we don't, how are we gonna get in there? And it's lighting that up, but I don't know what it means. I have no idea what it means. I guess it's time to look and see. See if it's worth it. Hang on. Temporal freeze. Just clear it all out. Just don't have the height for it. If I could somehow push them upwards to make a better platform, I could. I wish I could. But it seems like that's not gonna work. That is very interesting. But how do we manage to do it? Oh, it's spikes. Oh, what's that? Okay, that's peculiar. Did I just break it? Well, something I'm supposed to do up there. But freezing is not the key there. Definitely not. And if I fall down, then I end up, well, having to go through that, and that's the boss room. Oh boy. I guess I'll have to look through all the crystals and see if there's anything else we can find. Because we're still missing one key item. And that one's a blocked off prisoner, last I remember. So, yeah. Well, we'll at least figure this out eventually. For now, that's the end of this episode of Paradox Lost. So until next time, we will continue our search for the last item, as well as the remaining prisoners. Until then, I am Melcadrien, I'm signing off. Have a great day, guys, and happy gaming.